control of Al-Azhar University, in of course enhancing the national solidarity and also in combating terrorism and reaching the goals of the sustainable development of 2030 as well by the initiative Nahmiha, and of course Bilfikr Nahmiha, and we will be looking into that and more with Dr. Makhlouf Ibrahim, Executive Director of Creativity Center at Al-Azhar University. Welcome with us, Doctor.
Welcome to you. Welcome.
Sir, in light of the comprehensive operation taking place now in Sinai by the Egyptian army in order to fight terrorism, Al-Azhar is playing a role regarding this issue. What is the role played by the Al-Azhar?
Al-Azhar, by the leader of Dr. Ahmed Tayyib, Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, lead the project and lead the campaign to destroy cancer by enlightened thought and the middle thought. Al-Azhar is keen to spread the light thought and the middle thought and face terrorism and extremism by enlightened thought.
Yes, Doctor. Now, I understand that actually Bilfikr Nahmiha, the initiative started in January, and it started with a large group of professors from Al-Azhar University, and then they were joined by other university professors. So would you talk to us about that initiative in particular, please?
Our campaign interested in, firstly, to support our country, Egypt, and support the president Sisi in next election, next presidential election, because of President Sisi is keen to achieve very good benefit to our country, and we support our country firstly by providing innovative solution to problems that face our country Egypt, not traditional solution. Our campaign include member of staff of Al-Azhar University and the Egyptian University and experts in political, industry, economic, and athletes and artists and farmers and simple workers and all sectors, all Egyptian sectors.
Yes. We always hear that Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, Sheikh Ahmed Al-Tayyib, speaks about terrorism and its danger on any society. And he's always stressing on the role of Azhar to fight terrorism.
Yes.
How's that?
Al-Azhar cooperate with all organs of state. We fight terrorism by forced army and police, and Al-Azhar by leader of Grand Imam Dr. Ahmed Tayyib plays important roles to fighting and destruct terrorism by middle thought. Al-Azhar face the tourism by a light thought and the middle thought, and by against the extremism by a light thought and moderate and the middle thought. Al-Azhar and Crash also fighting against terrorism. All sectors of Egyptian peoples cooperate together and don't together against terrorism. Our state in this period presented a unique model to fighting terrorism worldwide. Country with armed forces and police and the Al-Azhar and the Crash presented a unique rules to fighting and destruct terrorism and extremism.
Yes, sir. Now, recently, the Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs held a conference where more than 150 participants took part in, and it was basically to fight terrorism and to spread enlightened thoughts. So would you tell us a bit about that, please?
Al-Azhar, as a general, is keen to fight terrorism, especially in this period by the leader of Grand Imam Dr. Ahmed Tayyib, and the cooperate and the Al-Azhar and the state and the British Sisi is interested to know the difference between Muslim and Christian. Know the difference, the religion to Allah, but homeland for all. That's the thought, that's the enlightened thought for Al-Azhar. And the Grand Imam traveled to abroad in many conference, and the spirit enlightened thought and the middle thought and rich, the civilized thought that appear, the civilized Islam to the world. The Islam is interested in peace. Peace is the name of Allah, and the Islam is interested. Al-Azhar is a leader as the Islamic in the world.
Sir, why mainly the younger generation fall an easy prey for terrorism? Is it out of depression, or is it out of what?
As I told, when we defeat and destruct and against terrorism, terrorists will be increased in our country and countryjet, and our country will be stable, and this lead to more tourists to Egypt and more national project. This lead to increase in our national income in our country. The stable, the security stable lead to more project, more national project.
Of course, stability leads to enhancement and development, but why the younger generation fall an easy prey for terrorism?
Yes, this need in the beginning, we need education. We need the middle education to the young. The President Sisi is interested in us, and we all must cooperate to educate the young people how to thought by the moderate thought of Al-Azhar, the moderate thought of the humanity as a general.
Doctor, during the Supreme Islamic Council's meeting, or the Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs meeting, which took place on the 28th of February, the statement of the Minister of Endowments, Mohammed Mukhtar, he said that actually the state's interests are not separate from the religious principles that call for unity and loyalty. How can we spread that thought?
We can spread the enlightened thought of Islam to abroad. Our media is played an important role to reach our soul to abroad. Our soul, the media is the role and an important role to reach the soul to abroad. Many people in abroad don't know enough about the enlightened of Islam.
How can that be done? Through conferences, missions, religious discourse abroad, social media? How do you feel that it should take place?
We can do this by cooperate with another country in abroad, and do many conference between the scientists of staff of Al-Azhar University. We can reach our soul to abroad by many conference. And
well, Dr. Makhlouf Ibrahim, Executive Director of the Creativity Center at Al-Azhar University, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Doctor. And now it's time to look at the latest trend in the social media and cruise online.